See that? Oh my God. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Julie and I am gonna show you some really exciting makeup finds that I have from the drugstore. The more I dive into affordable makeup, the more excited I am. I am thrilled with how my makeup turned out today and it's all drugstore. Two things are not drugstore, but the rest of it is drugstore. What I'm gonna be talking to you about today is the L'Oreal True Match. I've got Revlon Translucent Powder. I have Maybelline Fit Me. I have Maybelline Mascara. A lot of Maybelline lipstick and eyeshadow even. I'm so thrilled with the eyeshadow applications. So I hope you're as excited as I am to see how I got this look. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Julie Meikle and I'm a professional makeup artist and a licensed hairstylist. My videos consist of makeup, hair, and fashion. Fashion is new to me and I'm really having fun doing that. As I've gotten older, my makeup techniques have had to change just a little bit and it's more challenging, honestly. And also fashion is more challenging. My purpose of doing these videos is to help you out, to make your life easier, to inform you, and hopefully help you feel beautiful, whether that's with hair, makeup, or fashion. So that is my goal. If you want to see anything in my videos, if you want me to go through anything or try products, please let me know in the comments. If you are a returning viewer, thank you so much for being here. You encourage me every day to come back on here and give it another shot, and I really appreciate that. I literally asked the universe to give me positive women who want to lift each other up and really support each other as we get older. I know everybody talks about haters, but I haven't run into any of that, so I'm lucky to have you. If you resonate with my energy and you want to see more of my videos, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos. Hit the like button before you leave, share with all your friends, and let's get on with the video. I am going to show you some new foundations, to me anyways. I picked up the new L'Oreal True Match. Now, is this a new formulation? I picked this up at my local Shoppers Drug Mart. If you don't know already, I'm in Canada, and this just came into our local Shoppers Drug Mart. You guys in the US, you always get things first, so I was excited to see the new packaging. Let me tell you what it says from the website. It says, rediscover L'Oreal's True Match Super Blendable Foundation, a skincare-infused foundation available in 45 shades with the new skin matching technology, for the first time formulated with up to 6 pigments for our most precise skin undertone match. True Match is enriched with 80% moisturizing cream and hyaluronic acid, giving higher hydration to skin in 72 hours with repeated application and improving skin quality in just 2 weeks. If you guys haven't seen my channel before, one of my favorite foundations is from the drugstore and it's the L'Oreal True Match Serum Foundation. So I'm excited to try this one. I picked up 2N and 3N. It could be either one because I self-tan all the time and I'm never sure at what stage it's fading off. And I didn't self-tan my hands, so you can see my natural skin color is quite fair. I'm a natural ginger, so the Irish skin and the see-through skin as I'm now 51, almost 52. October, I'm 52 years old. Oh, the packaging. Okay, there we go. I like the packaging of this. So the serum foundation is one of the droppers. It's awful. It's so messy. This is much better. So I'm gonna put a swatch right here and I'm gonna leave it pretty heavy. And I feel already that that's gonna be too light. Now, if I were to put that actually on my skin here, yeah, that blends right in. So if I were my natural skin tone on my face, that would be my color. Oh, that feels really nice. That feels really nice, like silky nice. So easy to pump. Oh, it's actually quite fluid. Yeah, that's, let me put it beside it here, hold on. So I'm gonna let it dry for a minute. But already I can tell that this one is much better than the first one. What I would do if you bounce between colors is get a couple, they're not that expensive, and then you have your transition from your summer to your winter color. Yeah, that one's looking really good right there. So I've let that dry for a minute. And if you are in between two colors, cheat yourself to the darker color, unless you really like that fairness. But if you're somebody of my age, more of a mature skin, when we start having lines and texture in our skin, as soon as you put a lighter color foundation on, it's gonna enhance those lines and it's not good. You know, it's really will sit into those lines. So you're always better if you can cheat your color up just a smidge. I wonder with my tan if I could have gone with a 4N. I feel like I might have been able to do that. So I'm gonna go ahead with a 3N. When I apply foundation, I prefer to use a brush, partly because it's less expensive. So I can always wash my brushes and I never have to replace them. Once I buy a brush, it's there for life as long as I look after it. Where a sponge, well, you have to repurchase it over and over again. That's why I choose to use brushes and I'm just used to brushes. Oh, I do have, where is that? What's it called? Let me go get it. Hold on, I've had a brain fart. Just a second. That's too funny. As soon as I grabbed it, I remembered. So this is a Stansout sponge. I love this. First of all, it works really well, but also this thing lasts forever. I have washed this over and over and over again, and it has not fallen apart. Washes really nicely, and it doesn't disintegrate on me. It kind of feels like a memory foam, and it feels really good. And you can use this dry or wet. So I think I'm gonna do one side with a brush and one side with a sponge and we'll see how it goes. My favorite brushes are dirty. I actually think you could use your fingers with this one. It's quite a liquidy formula. You see it running down, which I love because that means it's going to look really, really natural. So a little bit will go a long way. I still have some on my hand. And I'm just gonna tap that in. I have all of my hyperpigmentation right there. That's the most important part to me when it comes to my foundation. That and the redness around my nose. By the way, I didn't put any primer on. I just want to see how it looks without primer. Typically, if I were to use a primer, I would probably put some pore filling primer in here. Honestly, I don't use a lot of primer. Wow. I would say that that matches perfect. And look at the coverage that gave me. What? So I've got some hyperpigmentation here and here. I should have done the before and after. My skin still looks like skin. It's glowy. It's not at all matte. And it's not sitting in my lines so far anyways. So I'm gonna go ahead and put it on with my finger and then I'll tap it out with the sponge. That's the other thing I find is that sometimes a sponge can soak up too much product and I feel like that's a waste of product. Nope, but that's good. Oh, this is great. Is this my new favorite? I'm just gonna put a little bit right there. A little bit right there. I self-tanned my face the other day and I thought, I'm just gonna do my face and neck for now and then I'll do my body tomorrow. And then today when I had a shower, I was too lazy. So that's why I'm so odd with my color. I actually might like this side better because I see less of the product. I put too much on. And that's the other thing. When you put too much on, if you go over it with a sponge, it will take the excess off. And I feel like that's what I need on this side. Isn't that interesting? You know, you get stuck in your habits. Like I really get stuck in my habits. And then it's fun trying new techniques because look at what I just learned. There, I almost feel like the light is too close to me. Maybe that's why it's whiting my face out. Okay, bear with me, guys. I might have to move out just a little bit. There we go. Ah, that's more of my coloring. See, I do actually match a little bit better. And well, yeah, and you can't see my mirror. I'm figuring it out, yay. Okay, good. I would love to keep this in the drugstore family today. That's what I'm gonna try to do. I have the L'Oreal True Match Eye Cream in a concealer. So let's see how this goes. I got C3 to 4. It is a little yellow. So let's see what that will look like. You know, I am more violet around here though. And if you look at a color wheel, the opposite of violet is yellow. So that actually looks pretty good. I'm just gonna put a little bit right there. If you ever notice this area right here, I have a patch of eczema. I don't know what's going on there. It's happened to me all summer. I've used a little bit of cortisone there and I've put some castor oil there to see if I could naturally get rid of it. And if I'm not on it regularly, it really can get crusty. I'm not sure why. I make sure not to put my retinol products and my active ingredients there because I feel like that's going to irritate it more. Probably allergies. I definitely have allergies. I take allergy medicine every day. Oh my God, you guys, this is the struggle when I'm filming on this camera. It needs to beep or something when the camera goes off. I have the Revlon Color Stay Day to Night in this color right here. This is a new and improved formula. It lasts up to 24 hours. I think it's called Decadent. I'm actually gonna contour first. Glow Skin Beauty is a mineral brand. It's very similar to Jane Ardell. I love this. This is the packaging right here. You can get this on Amazon. I will put a link in there for you. I love the concealers, I love the lips, I love the eyes, I love everything. I actually carried the whole line in my studio, and for me to carry a whole line and put that kind of money into something, it had to be really good, and it is. And maybe I'll do a dedicated video on the Glow Skin Beauty. I tried it on my sister-in-law. She has the most sensitive skin that you can possibly imagine. The poor girl just reacts to everything, and she's good with this makeup. So if you have sensitive skin, if you have eczema, if you have allergies, skin sensitivities at all, this is tested and approved. I'm actually going to use a Saint brush. I love their brushes. This is considered a cream blush, and this is in Warmth. And you can see that it is the perfect color for me. And I tap because I don't want to wipe and swipe. I already have issues there, so if I get too heavy-handed or too rough with that area, I'm going to remove all the coverage that I just worked so hard on getting. So I'm very, very light-handed with my brush. And it's cream, so it's really easy to blend. Do I have it even? It's a little bit darker on the other side, so I'm gonna put a little bit more. And I'm gonna push it up. So I don't want it to come down past this line. I also don't want it to look like a line. And here too. There's really nothing left on my brush now, and that's why I can kind of push it in a few different directions to make sure that it's diffused. Yeah, so I'm gonna powder a little bit. I never use these things. I don't know, maybe you would use this if you were traveling. Let's use it. I would put it right here and right here. That worked. I like placing it over my brows as well, because any moisture on my brows, it's gonna make my eyebrow pencil slide, and I want it to be able to really stick to my skin so that it stays. I'm gonna also take the oil off of my eyelids. Normally I would prime my eyelids for sure. Maybe I should just do that with what I usually use. This is in drugstore, but I'm gonna go ahead and use my MAC Painterly Paint Pot and even out my skin tone on my eyelids so that when I use those colors, it's not gonna fight against those violet veins. If you don't have discoloration on your eyes, don't worry about it. I think it's always important to prep your eyes with something, but it doesn't have to be as opaque as this one. This is generally why I use this though. Like other ones like Fenty Beauty or I don't know of drugstore ones. Again, I've got to educate myself more on the drugstore, but already that looks so much better. So I'm gonna go ahead and play with this one. I'm excited. So let's see how these look. Oh, they're super soft. Can you guys see that? It really feels silky, guys. I have a really good feeling about this. See, and this is why you venture out. What kind of look am I gonna do with this? I'm really excited about this dark color. I'm gonna start off with this color actually. And I think I'm just gonna take my hand and press it. Yeah, you see it's kind of flaking. I picked up a lot, so I don't know if you can see that. And by doing this, I'm hopefully not gonna get it on my cheeks. So tapping it off first, hopefully that will solve my issue before it starts. That is beautiful. Okay, so I've laid down my product in that kind of outer half. The darkest part being here, as I drag it in, it's gonna fade out, okay? And then whatever's left on my brush, I'm gonna drag it up here by doing circular motions. And the reason I have to bring it up here is because my eye is dropping, and if I only put it in the crease, you're not gonna be able to see it, and it's actually gonna make my eye look smaller. So I'm gonna take it over the crease and light circular motions, pull it up. Now, if you don't like shimmer, this is not for you, because this is all shimmer. Now you can see the difference. I didn't pull this one up higher, and this one looks bigger and wider, looking straight ahead, dragging up. One eye always droops more than the other. It's really hard to get everything equal, It's like you have one foot bigger than the other, one hand bigger than the other usually. This eye for me droops down more than this eye. But nobody's looking. Nobody's looking. It just doesn't matter. When people see you, they're just gonna see how pretty you look. And I'm making sure to get right in the hollow there. I don't know if you can see that, but there's kind of a hole right there. So I wanna go back, put a little bit more there. Hopefully I got it even. Okay, new brush. I might use my finger. I think I'm gonna use the yellow or the gold, and I'm gonna pop it right there, right in the center. Which one should I use? I don't wanna go quite as light as this one, so I'm gonna use this one right here. It's hard to see the difference, but so it's kind of more of a pinky tone. I'm gonna use a brush for this one. I'm gonna put it right in there. A really good matte shadow palette that's inexpensive is e.l.f. I have one of them here. It's really good. I'm gonna wipe this brush off on a towel. This I used for painting. And I'm gonna take this empty brush and just go over the edges, making sure that it's all blended and soft, and wiping it off on a towel again, and same thing. I'm just gonna go in underneath. I have a lot of sparse areas, and really it should come in closer here in towards the nose. So I wanna add a few more hairs right there. Oh, brows make such a difference. Let me know in the comments, what is your favorite brow product? Sometimes I rush through my brows, and then when I edit, I see all the holes. Don't forget, my eyes are getting old. It's hard to see. I'm not used to going without an eyeliner, so wish me luck, because this is a little bit dusty. I'm gonna do the same thing and tap it here. Try to get the excess off, and then go underneath my lashes. And you can see how that gives a really nice soft shadow and a cohesive look. It makes my eye look so much bigger, and it doesn't have to be a lot. It can be a fairly thin line, and I don't have any fallout, so tapping it on my hand worked really well. How much did I pay for this? So it's on sale right now at Shoppers Drug Mart for $13.59, and I'm pretty sure that's why I bought it, was because it was on sale. The regular price is $16.99. So if you're in the US, I'm sure you can get it at Ulta or CVS. You know, mascaras aren't that cheap. This is $18.99. So hopefully this will be nice. All right, let's see how this goes. I can never really tell if I like a mascara. I may like it tonight, and then a few days from now, I might not like it, but I do know right away if I don't like it. It all depends on how it goes on and how it builds. So far, so good. It's applying a small amount of product, which isn't a bad thing because it's not getting clumpy. It's a very natural looking lash, but I always build it up. I do at least two coats, sometimes three. So we'll see how that goes. But if you just are a one coat person, this is what it looks like so far. It's kind of nice. It's got a flat piece right there. I don't know if you can see that, so that you can sit it on your counter and it doesn't roll off. It's not so wet that I'm getting marks on my lid, which is also nice. I'm also being very careful. This has had time to sit, so I'll do a second coat right now. I don't like allowing it to dry fully because then it gets kind of sticky. Yeah, it's building nice. It's hard to do it without the mascara face. I got this mascara comb on Amazon. I love combing them out. I'm missing all my outside lashes. I made a mess, of course. It's because I'm trying to put mascara on an area that I don't even have lashes. I don't know what happened. Keep repeating that in all my videos, but I'm so sad. Where did they go? Oh, I'm gonna put lipstick on. I'm such a nude person. This looks like it's my lips. Yeah, I think it does look like my lips. I like the smell of them. So this is a Maybelline Superstay. Oh, and it has a sharpener. Oh, I didn't know that. So it's got the sharpener on the one end. Good thing I read that. And this is in the color. Where are my glasses? The heck? Does it not have a name? Are you freaking kidding me? What lipstick doesn't have a name? I have a couple girlfriends on TikTok. They love these. That's actually really pretty. Oh, It's on the lid. It's called Trust Your Gut. Oh, I really like that color. All right. I like to use a fluffy, soft brush for blushes, especially if I don't know what it's gonna look like. The softer the brush, the softer the application, and the easier it's gonna blend. So building this up, I'm tapping in pretty hard, and you can see that it's not going crazy on my brush. So I think I'm gonna be pretty safe. I like being able to build up my blushes rather than having to worry about putting too much on and then having to work to blend it out. I've seen a lot of people use the Infallible blushes from L'Oreal. When they first apply it, they go, whoa. And I wanna try one, but I'm not attracted to any of the colors as of yet. Maybe it was just what my drugstore had. Oh, that's pretty. Oh, I really like this. I'm excited. I could keep adding more. I am thrilled. Okay, I wanna show you this trick and we'll see if it works. So my lashes could look much curlier. It happens that when I put mascara on, it doesn't matter if it's a curling mascara or not. As soon as I put mascara on, it kind of drops down a little bit, which is normal. You know, you're adding some weight to your lashes. And when I've tried to curl my lashes after the fact, I actually think that that's maybe what I did to these corner lashes, and it gets stuck to my curler and it's painful to get off, and then you can rip your lashes out. She used some loose powder. I'll show you. She dusted her lash curler with, I can't think of my words, with the powder so that it won't stick. So we'll see. I'm nervous. My lashes break, I'll be upset. I wonder if it will leave a residue of the powder though. Oh! Look it. See that? Oh my God. And it didn't stick. This woman is a genius. I'm gonna have to tag her below. I'll put her in the description box. Look at that. What a difference. It looks like I have false lashes on. And I don't see a residue of the powder on my mascara. I was watching her do this and I'm like, oh, why didn't I think of that? That was such a good idea. Okay, and again. She's a genius. She may not have been the only one to think of it, but I have never seen that before. I think I saved it. That's how important this was to me. This is the girl here, and her name is Rose and Ben on Instagram. I'll put her in below. She's very, very smart. She's a talented makeup artist. Look at it, I'm so happy. All right, so what I'm noticing is my skin, I'm not sure if you can see this, but I have a little bit of radiance there. I would not put any highlighter on my skin. I'm 51, I have texture there. As soon as I start adding highlighter, I just enhance everything that I don't want to see. So I think my skin looks great the way it is. And my lipstick looks good too. That's all I'm gonna do. I'm happy with my makeup. My foundation, I think my skin looks so good. I would say that this is at least as good as my high-end foundations. Yeah, I think the color matches really well. I actually might buy a 4N just to have in my collection for when I freshly self-tan, because this is actually a few days old. Let me know if you guys want to see a video about my tanning routine. There's one product that I keep going back to, and I tried others, but I continue to use this other brand. It's called Luna Bronze. I can show you the before and afters and do a video on that. I'm gonna link all these products for you in my description box. I'm also gonna link some other videos that I've done recently. If you're interested in seeing a demonstration of the Laura Mercier caviar sticks, I put one up, I think, last week. I have some fashion clothing hauls on here as well, and I'll link those below. My most recent one was The Gap, and I really had good luck there. So I'll put that in the description box as well. If you like this video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button before you leave. Leave your comments. I love getting to know you guys, and I hope this helps, and I will see you later. Bye.